trouble.
Well, goodness gracious me.
For every time a certain man is standing next to me, a flash comes to my face and my pulse begins to race. It goes boom, booty, boom, booty, boom, booty, boom, booty, boom, booty, boom, booty, boom, 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 booty, boom, booty, boom, booty, boom.
Well, goodness gracious me. How often does this happen? When did the trouble start? You see, my stethoscope is bobbing to the throbbing of your heart.
What kind of man is he to create this allergy? It goes boom, booty, boom, booty, boom, booty, boom, booty, boom, booty, boom, booty, boom, 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 booty, boom, booty, boom, booty, boom.
Well, goodness gracious me.
Tell him he's not going to die. You're not going to die. He is going to die. Not now, of course. 10, 15 years. Who knows? I don't. We wouldn't want to lose you now, would we? And off he goes. Sentence suspended. Another 10 years. Another 10 years of showing the slides. That's Malcolm, Paulie, and baby Jason. Another 10 years of going for little runs in the car. And that's us at the safari park. So, what did the doctor say, dear? Oh, nothing. Nothing. It's all in the imagination. Really? It's not all in the imagination. Sometimes, I'm afraid, it actually happens.
Oh!
Stopping at every lamppost. No time.
Next we have...
I can manage, thank you. Elocution was always my strong point. Speak clearly, speak firmly, speak now. Name, Quicksteed, Muriel Jane. Age, but if I said 50, you'd be in the target area. Wife, to said Arthur Wicksteed. And golly, don't I know it. Still potty about it then. The dirty dog. Shut up, Mira!
And now, this is Dennis, only son of Arthur and Muriel Wicksteed. Dennis, what do you do?
Nothing very much. I think I've got lockjaw.
Really? Whereabouts?
All over.
And are you interested in girls at all?
If they're clean.
Well, that goes without saying. You don't want a dirty girl, do you?
In a way, I do, yes.
And now, this is Connie. Connie is a 33-year-old spinster.
I'm not a spinster. I'm a man.
boyfriends, dear?
No.
Connie, you big story. What about Canon Throbbing, our Christian young vicar? That sounds like his bicycle now. Now, Connie, would you like to tell the audience what your ambition is? Go on, just whisper.
I'd like a big bus. And what would you do with it?
Get out!
25 years in the pursuit of the profession of medicine, a profession to which I unwittingly gave myself in my callow youth. People have been taking their trousers off in front of me at the average rate of about 5 times a day, 5 days a week, 52 weeks in the year. That means that as a conservative estimate, without some temptation, I've seen roughly 25,000 sets of private parts. The most conscientious whore could not have seen more. In the light of such statistics, you are displaying not so much modesty as arrogance. Now get them off! Well, we were taught many things at medical school, Padre, but seen through several thick layers of wince yet was not one of them. Oh, yes. Turn around. Bend over. Get any feelings of nausea at all? Well, God knows I do. It's all guesswork, you know. I peer up their noses, delve into their ear holes. I'm glued to every orifice of the body like a parlor made at a keyhole. Shut up! And so it goes on. Day after day, week after week, they troop in with their sore throats and their varicose veins. They parade before me, skin the color of tripe and the texture of junket. Is this the image of God? This sagging parcel of vanilla blancmange, hoisted day after day onto the consulting room table. Is this the precious envelope of the soul? Is this
on the National Health?
No. Why do you want to get married, anyway?
Because I look at girls' legs.
Aha. Marriage won't stop that.
Won't it?
I'm afraid not.
So you still do?
Me? No. I'm a doctor.
Well, I do, and I'm a clergyman.
Oh, my poor sister. Because she's flat-chested, he thinks she's religious.
I just love him!
Love? You look on the shelf and you'll find it cluttered with dozens of spinsters gathering dust. All of them nailed. I was waiting for love. I married Arthur for love, and look what I got. The mucky end of the stick. I could kick myself.
Do you know who I could have married?
Do you know who I could have married?
Sir Percy Shorter.
Sir Percy Shorter.
Twice the man Arthur ever was.
Twice the man Arthur ever was.
Or will be.
Or will be. I get to look more and more like the Queen Mother every day.
Margaret.
Yes?
I've got 3 months to live.
3 months? 2 months ago, you only had 10 days.
I made a mistake.
And what happened to the galloping consumption you had last Thursday? Slowed down to a trot, I suppose.
I've got a very rare disease.
You've got an extremely common disease. You've got a case of the can't help it. Better go ask your father.
He doesn't care.
That's true enough.
It's called Brett's palsy. It has spots, tiredness, and irritability.
Spots? Yes. Tiredness and irritability. If this disease is confined to the Caucasus, what is it doing in Hove?
Over here for the halls, I suppose.
Tragic. And he went through puberty with such flying colours.
Every day, in every way, they're getting bigger and bigger and bigger.
I'm going to die, Connie.
Every day, in every way, they're getting bigger and bigger and bigger.
I'm dying and no one will believe me.
Her hobbies are water skiing and world peace.
That's my magazine.
Someone hid it on top of the wardrobe. If I had those, I wouldn't need hobbies. No, dear, look. Send off this postcard and a beautiful bust can be yours this summer for just £5.
£2.50 each.
Both ones? Do you think so?
I would, Connie, if it were me.
Connie? Has a title. She's your aunt, Connie.
Aunt is the title.
It's the closest you'll ever get to one. Calling your aunt by her Christian name? I knew a girl once who called her parents by their Christian names.
had a baby before she was 17. And what was the father's name? She hadn't even bothered to ask. So much for names.
It's no use! Look at my legs!
Very nice legs, if you ask me. There are people running around with no legs at all who would be more than happy to wear yours.
I'm feeling much better.
glad. It's a bit untidy. Old, I suppose, without being old-fashioned. Carpet's a bit thin. Plumbing's a bit noisy sometimes, too. It smells even. Tobacco, drink. But I tell you, it's a good deal better than any of these gimcrack things you can pick up these days. Even if it is a bit run down.
Yes?
Yes. Hello. Wicksteed Surgery. Wicksteed speaking. Ah, Mr. Purdue. One moment, please. This is an interesting call. One that highlights how pivotal a role we doctors play in the community. I've always made a point of it to make myself available for anyone in need, anyone in despair. Anyone in particular contemplating suicide?
Suicide?
This patient, Mr. Purdue, is on the brink of self-destruction. But before he actually attempts to take his own life, he calls me his family doctor, knowing I will be there.
Poor man.
A kind voice, a friendly word, will often just tip the balance between life and death. We'll turn back from embarking on a journey to that country from whose born, as Shakespeare so well put it, no traveller returns. So, if you'll excuse me, I'll just have a word with him. Strictly speaking, of course, I shouldn't, because you're a private patient.
He isn't. I don't mind.
That's most magnanimous of you.
No, I'm quite happy.
I only wish Mr. Purdue was. Hello, Mr. Purdue. Mr. Purdue. Hello. He seems to have hung up. I'm wondering whether I ought to give you a little examination.
Uh-huh.
There would appear now would not be the best time. One moment.
It used to be so flat. Can you tell? In 43, that I met him. We had just had a day by the sea. Now he's gone and he's left me expecting. Oh, will somebody please?
Hello. I've got Brett's palsy and I've only got 3 months to live.
Really?
Yes, at the outside.
That's tragic.
I'm glad somebody thinks so.
You're so young.
Don't touch me. Are you sure you haven't got any disease?
No, you have.
Yes, but I don't want any complications, do I?
You poor private boy.
Please don't tell my father. He's a doctor.
Perhaps he could heal you.
Him? He couldn't heal a shoe.
This disease, you say, there's no cure.
None.
And in 3 months, you'll be dead.
I'm certain.
Look, I'd like to see him again. Can I?
Me? You must be peculiar.
I would, really.
When? I don't have much time.
Thursday, 2:30. Where?
Here?
My name's Felicity. What's yours?
Dennis. Trevor. What are you doing here? You've no business in the consulting room.
Goodbye, Penelope.
Felicity!
Yes.
My son, I'm afraid. Trevor.
He said his name was Dennis.
Did he? Then it probably is. Listen, the doctor-patient relationship is such an important one. One of mutual trust and respect. And here you are, such a shy, young, innocent creature. And I'm somewhat elder. It would help. It would help me, I think, if we could perhaps break the ice a bit and go for a spin in the car. Anytime. Say, Thursday at 2:30.
My mother's very strict.
Splendid. We'll meet at the end of the pier.
Oh!
You won't be late.
Never late.
That was too late.
To the low at 53.
He was finished.
A worn defeat. To like me, steal the teeth, the lusty vows, long stretches of my wing out. Thus, tea girls in flowered skeleton, keep chin down, say my companion, easing off their wet boots, to step into their burdens. No, I am abusing my position as their trusted ale physician. Virtue.
to it. Just to pass it by, this lump of soot.
I see it goes through the rubble. That's what this girl needs to tumble.
Who was that?
Only a patient.
Man or woman?
They're all the same to me.
How old are we, Arthur?
You're 51 and I'm...
53.
And it seems like only yesterday I was 16.
When did the fire go out, Arthur?
What?
Nothing. It isn't as if he's attractive. I'm much more attractive than he is. If only he would stretch out his hand and call my name.
Muriel?
Yes.
It is your cake decorating class on Thursday.
Yes. Why?
Then you won't be wanting the car.
No. Why?
I'm attending the open session of the BMA conference.
Indeed, the house will be empty.
I'll put an end to this duplicity, but not before I've had Felicity. Oh take this heat away. Lest my ruin end this play.
Hello, Dr. Wicksteed's residence. Speaking. Oh, Percy.
That'll be Sir Percy Sherwin, some references already leave me.
After all these years, longing to. Well, why not here? Thursday afternoon. No, the doctor will be out. Splendid. How exciting. Mum's the word. Kiss. Kiss. Kiss.
It's the afternoon of the Thursday in question. And lunch just cooked by the fair hands of Guess Who is just over. I started them off with a little plate of soup with scattered croutons, followed by a fricassee of lamb with just a hint of rosemary. Then they had the apple charlotte, or the cheese board, followed by wafer thin mince and a choice of beverages. I think they enjoyed it.
It was disgusting.
Do you think this hat suits me? Of course it needs somebody who can pull it off. You can't skulk about in a hat like this.
Has anybody seen my wool? Where did you have it last?
I think you should look in what is inappropriately, in your case, named your breast pocket.
He's another picture of Sir Percy addressing the conference.
He hasn't grown an inch in 20 years.
Size isn't everything.
She's early.
He's early.
I'll go! I own the door. It's not a person. It's a parcel.
A parcel?
A parcel?
A parcel. For Miss Winston.
For me?
Yes.
I'm expecting it.
Who's it from?
I don't know.
You're expecting it, and you don't know who it's from. I've never heard of that before.
I have. My surgery's full of girls expecting something, and they don't know who it's from.
Nothing mysterious. Not that I'm the least bit curious. Jack a dull boy. And talking of dull boys, what are your plans?
A long walk in the fresh air.
Splendid. And you?
Can't fly!
I'm going to my cake decorating class. I don't really want to go, but we're electing a new secretary,
And it's like anything, if the rank and files don't go, the militants will take over.
Teach me.
I was wondering.
Yes.
Could we go for a walk?
That's too hot for walking.
Yes, I suppose it is.
But we could walk a little. Then throw ourselves down in some lush, warm, sun-scented meadow.
I get hay fever.
Oh, we could pause by a sparkling stream and perch together on some cool moss-grown rock.
I get piles.
Nature is hard.
I can take my raincoat.
What a brilliant idea.
Felicity.
Yes?
I'm getting this strange feeling. I think I might be coming down with something.
Bless them. I think they've clicked. Scorpio and Sagittarius. Lovely combo. Well, I think I'll have a glass of the Lancet.
You!
The mistress of the house. I wasn't expecting your return.
Yes, I've returned unexpectedly. An unforeseen hitch of my cake decorating glass. A shortage of hundreds and thousands would pay to the proceedings. Anyway, I thought I gave you the afternoon off.
I am an indefatigable worker.
You are a nosy. Parker, if you're so anxious to be working, there's one or two groceries waiting to be picked up.
Where?
Sainsbury's, where else? That takes care of her for the next few hours.
Brick! 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 On thy cold grey stones, O sea, would that my tongue could utter the words that arise in me. Would that it could, but you see, Felicity, I'm rather a shy person. Are you, Doctor? Don't call me Doctor. Call me Arthur.
Are you, Arthur?
Now that you mention it, I suppose I am. But you, Felicity, you will somehow restore my faith in humankind. Remind me of what perfection the human body is capable. In spirit, oh yes, in spirit. To think I was already qualified before you were born. I might have brought you into this world. Felt the first fragrant flutter of your life, cradled you in my arms, stroked your tiny face.
Arthur?
Yes, Felicity?
Arthur, you could still.
Could I? Oh, Felicity.
Percy. Oh, good afternoon. I'm looking for someone by the name of Wicksteed. W-I-C-K-S-T-E-E-D. Wicksteed, yes?
Yes.
And I think I found her.
Four marks,
10 out of 10. Mr. Shanks is their name. They are wonderful. Wonderful.
You think so?
They are outstanding. Outstanding.
Your appreciation after all these years.
And what a charming home.
In my goodness, don't they enhance it?
The balance, dear lady, almost perfect. Almost, but not quite. But that's what I'm on. That's what I'm here for. May I?
Society.
I believe this one is a fraction bigger than the other.
To hell with symmetry! Oh, how that touch revives me.
It will not have escaped to notice that the customer, Miss Wicksteed, is becoming a little excited.
At last, a tenant for my fallow loins.
However, rest assured, this excitement is not mutual.
I am an expert. A crest-course at Leatherhead, the firm's training centre set in the heart of Surrey's rural surroundings, lays down a standard procedure for every eventuality. Mind you, these are exceptional. I've only seen one pair of all these, and she's now the manageress of the only cinema in Fleetwood. You're such an outstanding example. I often compare notes with my colleagues and I. And since I've got my little Polaroid handy,
I was wondering when you were going to mention that. Your Polaroid, your lovely little Polaroid.
Just for the record.
Yes, record. Music.
You'd be just as immoral. Nobody's perfect. I'm 53. And the tide's going out. Arthur Wicksteed, MD.
No! Please! No!
I am Diana. You are my quarry. I'm stalking you of all alive, Grace of a Panda.
Does anybody know the darling colour of a leveret?
I'm chosen for the kill. My horse tore my flanks. Bring
me. No!
My head goes down and I pounce you!
I'm looking for Miss Wicksteed. Percy, do you not recognize me? Muriel? You haven't changed. She's enormous.
Do you two know each other?
No.
How do you do?
How do you do?
I suppose you're... Well, in case you're your husband. What is he doing in his shirt tails?
He's a patient.
A patient?
What did you think he was? My lover?
What are you laughing at? You've got no trousers on.
You can explain that.
Did anyone ask you?
No.
Are you a private patient?
No.
Then shut up. Unbalanced?
Mad. He only called in for his tranquilizers.
Don't worry. I have some with me.
You have to pad up your underpants when she's around. Oh, I can tell you.
Really?
She's mad.
Me?
Ha! She laughed a scornful laugh.
Here, take these.
No.
I am the president of the British Medical Association. Take them.
No.
Very well, Muriel. We must go intravenous.
She took more trousers off.
What for?
What does someone usually take another person's trousers off for?
You tell me.
She wanted
my body.
Your body? Your body? Thank you, Muriel. In case of doubt, just knock them out.
What?
When heckles rise, I tranquilize.
They do less harm if you keep them calm.
All I wanted was the telephone for Leatherhead.
This is the way we genuinely telephone Leatherhead. That's it. Up you get.
Does anybody know the darling code for Leatherhead?
Typical of your husband.
Arthur?
Leaving a patient running loose about the place.
It wasn't really his fault.
Slapdash and inconsiderate. I don't suppose he's changed.
You haven't either.
Hello.
I never liked him. He wanted I was small. You're a fool, Muriel.
What?
To throw yourself away on that little nobody. Still, I suppose he makes you happy.
Arthur, he falls asleep as soon as his teeth hit the glass.
Oh, Percy!
Is he about your husband? I'd quite like to see him. The eyes have doubtless taken their toll.
No, he's at the open session.
What open session? There is no open session today.
Are you certain?
Of course. I am the president. How else could I be here?
You were quick.
I had a following wind.
Where is the doctor?
The doctor? He's on the pier.
I feel the worst.
Death?
Sex! And if I know him, he's with a patient.
A patient? Indeed. First item on the agenda, get your things on. Second, a trip to the pier. Come on, buck up. And third, the ruin of a certain general practitioner. Take careful note of all you see.
I will.
Yes.
And who knows? This could be a blessing in disguise.
Disguise?
We'll be free.
Free.
And the future will be ours.
Ours.
No fear but revenge. Ha! After all these years.
All these years.
I think we need a booster.
Booster?
As the sun went down on that long afternoon, a lean, distinguished figure might have been observed standing for all of an hour at the end of a pier. Several times he made as if to greet solitary ladies as they approached. But each time he fell back, disappointed and alone.
Upstairs. Miss Christine, your visitor! Well, what do you think?
How nice to see somebody keeping up with the old ways. Oh, God! Think of all the years I've wasted. This is the sort of woman I've been looking for. Bold, provocative, with an ardor equal to mine. Come, let me clasp your urgent young body. Kiss me! Again! You earth maiden, will you marry me?
And I've only had them all 5 minutes! This is what they must be by the permissive society. Can I ask you something?
Yes.
Are you supposed to wash them?
You mean you don't?
No, not yet.
You mad, wretched creature.
I thought of brushing them. I thought a wire brush that might do.
Trousers. Oxfam. Zambia will be so grateful.
Come, come.
What is this? My bride to be the ultimate man. Before we're even married.
My fiance.
Stand back. She has fainted. I'm a doctor.
You don't look like a doctor to me. You haven't any trousers on. You're like a cad. And a loose fish. Get away with any of the prostrate body of my fiance in your ugly clothes. That is my privilege.
She thought she could seduce me.
Seduce? Her? I've been engaged to Miss Brookstead for 10 years, and she has not yet laid a finger on me.
King Sex is a wayward monarch.
Come on, stand up and fight. Stand up.
I am standing up.
You might want a handicap on account of your size.
What did you say?
I'm bigger than you are.
What gives you that idea?
One doesn't exactly need to be a quantity surveyor. Little squirt.
Little?
Oh, look, can't we just talk this over? I know quite a lot of small people in my time.
Small, small!
I don't heard anyone sign against them. We don't know how big Shakespeare was, do we? And look at Hitler. Mind, he's a bad example. Oh, Connie, are you all right?
Yes.
Has this man been interfering with you?
Yes, yes, oh yes, I'm going to marry him.
Him?
Why not, sailor?
Yes, why not? He found something in me I never knew was there.
Connie, what are those?
They're a recent development.
What is his name?
I haven't asked.
You're going to marry him and you don't even know his name?
Yes, I do know his name. His name is curtains billowing wide on a summer's night. His name is a secret special rose pressed in an old boot. His name is the name of all the lovers down the ages who have cried their challenge against the wild night and dared to cast themselves on the frail bark of love. What is your name, by the way?
Sir Percy Shorter. It's not my fault if I send women mad.
Mad? You? You Mickey Mouse, why don't you marry someone your own size?
It's the time to...
For evensong.
That settles it. You are a clergyman. Start saying your prayers.
Oh.
That is dropping. As your pinky nose is dropping, newly returned from Addis Ababa.
Welcome to our shores.
What are you doing?
The balance of his mind is disturbed. I'm about to redress it.
Oh! Oh!
How do you think it will happen then?
I imagine I just sort of fade away, really. Don't let's talk about it.
How tragic. A widow at 22.
I don't want to think about it anymore.
No. I too will be brave. I will be more than brave. I will be plucky. Felicity, his plucky young wife, survives him.
All the loves will flee. All the germs will flee before the greatest of medicines.
Love?
Sex. We the girly rather steady, so it's time to go to bed, each other lights down
below. Oh.
No betrayal headed, we're heading for a wedding day.
No.
Someday the star will pay a visit. And in a little souvenir. Just a little cute, what is it? You go home and get your knickers and I'll race you to the thickers and it ends away.
Don't anticipate it, wait to consummate it. Not every day is a wedding day.
what they must mean by the permissive society. Penelope.
Felicity.
Ah, is this your long walk in the fresh air?
It's all right.
All right. You lay your active face in Miss Rumsey's lap.
Good afternoon, Miss Rumsey.
And you say it's all right?
It's mutual.
Mutual? Ha! It's never mutual. Get off, get off. Be careful, I implore you, Miss Rumsey. That head is riddled with dandruff. Get out, you lounge lizard. You're not fit to hold a candle to Miss Rumsey. Never mind anything else. How can you forgive me? In my own house?
That is nice.
Stop! Do not couple your name with his, lest he should even contemplate touching your fresh, clean, young body. Fills me with such shame, such loathing. Filth! Filth! How can you forgive me?
No. Do not touch me.
No. How can I approach you? How can I even speak to you? The merest thing about you. The spent carpet of your lipstick, the fluff in your handbag's bottom, the dry bed of your compact. I am as but dirt and violence beside it. But, speaking thus, I speak as a man. And as a man, I cannot touch you. But, as a doctor.
Does that make a difference?
Oh, yes. As a man, I see you as a fresh, clean, passionate creature. But as a doctor, you are to me an organism, a machine, a mere carcass. As a doctor, I am a unit. I touch you without feeling and without desire.
Yes.
Now I touch you as a man.
Yes.
Now I touch you as a doctor.
Yes.
You see the difference. So have no fears when in a few short moments I shall ask you to remove your clothes in their entirety. Because I shall be as far from desire as is a plumber uncovering a manhole. How well I understand your fears. Life is such a dirty business these days. Everyone trying to grab what he can. What is the poem?
I don't know.
A young Diana, golden-haired, stands dreaming on the verge of strife. Woefully unprepared for the long littleness of life. Are you prepared for that, Felicity? The long littleness. Sometimes longer, sometimes littler. It comes as quite a shock to some girls, but others just take it in their stride. Oh, hello. Hello, ears. Hello, eyes. Hello, nose. Hello, mouth. Hello, fingers. Hello, knees. Hello, Bertie. I was just giving this young lady an aspirin.
In her underclothes.
It's very hot in here.
Don't worry, dear. I have a diploma in tropical medicine. Felicity. I don't think you know Sir Percy Shorter,
President of the British Medical Association.
Is this young lady a patient of yours?
The idea that a doctor of my reputation would meddle with a patient is repugnant to me. Leave my ears alone, will you, darling? And if not a patient, then what?
You tell me!
A friend. A family. The whole family. Like you. Strange, because she's not a bit like you. Out of my pockets, then. Nothing in my trousers pocket of any interest to you. Humbugs, you know. She knows I keep them there.
You're old enough to be her father.
So are you.
She wasn't tickling my ears.
That's true. Miss Rumbers, why don't you tickle Bertie's ears? I don't think she wants to.
Enough of this. Shall I tell you what I think?
No.
Yes. I think this young lady is a patient, that you are abusing your position to interfere with her, that you are a blackguard, that this is a scandal, that it is my duty to bring your little games to the notice of the Medical Disciplinary Committee, that I'll do all in my power to have you struck off.
No.
What do you have to say to that?
You little prat.
Who are you calling a little? Arthur!
Muriel!
I have just discovered your husband with his tongue down this young lady's throat.
Kissing?
Kissing? Slash! I fear kissing was just the tip of the iceberg.
marriage has been a mockery. My body lying there night after night in the wasted moonlight. I now know how the Taj Mahal must feel.
Listen, I can explain everything.
Save it for the degree now, sir.
Divorce? We can't get divorced. Think of our son, Trevor.
Dennis.
He will be the child of a broken home. He will probably turn to juvenile delinquency.
He's too old for juvenile delinquency.
Well, thank God for that.
Mention of divorce and avenues open up all around. Think of a person. A manageress at one of our leading London hotels, catering for an international clientele, where I can put my use of languages to good use.
You have no use of languages.
A smile knows no frontiers. Thank goodness I'm not alone.
And now, suddenly, at this moment of rejection, she goes knock, knock, knock at the door of my heart. And through a gap in the chintz, I see the ghost of an old passion.
Come, Muriel, lean on me.
Excuse me, Doctor.
You'll have to excuse me. I have been off. I have lost my career. I have lost my wife. Now you are all I have left.
Me?
Yes, but we can be happy together, Felicity. Together we can defy the world, snap our fingers at public opinion. What do you say, Felicity?
Can I help you, Mr. Purdue?
Nobody can help me.
Don't say that.
I won't mention my engagement for the moment. She'll understand, of course. Sensible girl. Never been the clinging type.
I'm going to do it.
Come, Percy. Come into the house of my body. Shelter from the storms of life like the eaves of my dress.
I am going to do it.
What do you say?
Actually, I'm already spoken for.
Spoken for? By whom?
Dennis.
Dennis. Who's Dennis?
Your son, Dennis.
Leonard? Oh, my God.
I'm going to do it. I am Amy.
What are you doing? Stand on my chest.
Does this happen? When did the trouble start? You see, my stethoscope is bobbing to the throbbing of your heart.
What kind of man is he to create this allergy? It goes boom, booty, boom, booty, boom, booty, boom, booty, boom, booty, boom, booty, boom, 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 booty, boom, booty, boom, booty, boom.
Well, goodness gracious me.
Some people will do anything for effect.
I don't really want to commit suicide. It took the call for help.
Sit! I see I got through in any time. Felicity, put that young man's hand back where it belongs and kick some clothes off.
Yes, Mother.
Who is depressing you?
My son. He depresses me too.
Not too depressed to take my daughter's clothes off.
No, you were.
He didn't!
Take no notice of my wife. She is his mother.
And you are his father.
Don't remind me.
Wixie did it! He is the culprit.
Yes, yes, I did it. I am his father. I turned him into this snivelling, loathsome little lecher. Where did I go wrong? Where do we go wrong, we parents, generation after generation?
It's all lies! I can tell you what happened. I don't believe we've had the pleasure.
Allow me. This is Delia, Lady Rumpus.
Another titled perfect person. What a breath of fresh air. Lady Rumpus, I am a doctor.
Another doctor?
Then I don't want to hear another word. I've had a belly full of doctors.
I want a doctor. I'm depressed.
So would I be if I had my head in a noose.
I only want to put one foot in the grave.
Hey, this is intolerable! Felicity, it shouldn't take all day for you to get your skirt on.
Can I help?
Don't touch her.
No! Get back. You've done enough damage already.
Me?
Control yourself.
Jerry, so much seem to look at a girl like Felicity.
Yes.
No!
You are dirt.
Dirt.
Feel.
Feel.
Mother, he's sick.
Yes. Sick, sick, sick. You toad.
If you'd allow me.
Shut your
your face!
Dad! Dad!
Don't you dad me.
To think we've only been in this country for 3 weeks and everywhere's the same. Sex! 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 Well, I'm not having any!
I'm not surprised!
When I get you back last week to the Claremont, you came straight to Hot Bath and I'm going to personally scrub you all over with carbolic.
Ah, the privileges of motherhood.
Ooh, perhaps you'll believe me now, Felicity. Men will touch you, rob you, and rattle you of all you possess.
Flesh isn't property, you know.
Yes, it is. What is one's body but property? What is one's own flesh and blood but made precious inheritance? When that is spent, one is indeed bankrupt of everything. From this moment on, I will not let her out of my sight. Haile Selassie was right. We should never have left Addis Ababa.
You slid out of that very well.
I did, rather.
I want you out of this house in half an hour.
Yes, I must go and collect my thoughts and pack.
And we must have a little talk, Percy, about the future.
Yes.
Our future.
Has everybody gone?
Anybody of any consequence?
Marvellous.
It's all self in this house. Locked in our tiny domestic tragedies, only I, Amelia Swab, can take the wider view. What seems to be the trouble?
I'm depressed.
Pisces is in the second quarter of Saturn. Naturally, you're depressed.
Wait a minute. I am Pisces.
Well, why don't you look on the bright side? Next week the sun will be shining in Saturn and Pisces will be laughing.
I have no sympathy with him at all. None.
He is my husband.
I don't understand how he could betray such a fine body.
Nor do I.
As the British Medical Association. What more does he want?
Well, not more. Different.
And a doctor entrusted with the bodies of his patients, caught red-handed.
Yes, red-handed. And yours so plump and white.
Please, Muriel. We've all been tempted. Every doctor has. The lowliest locum in the back streets of Liverpool can take advantage of a patient, if he allows himself, because the doctor-patient relationship is itself a kind of seduction. If one says, no, no, body, I will not do this. No, no, hands, keep to your appointed task. No, no, eyes, stick to the affected part. That is what professionalism means, yes?
Have you ever?
Never, never! Though I've had my chances, discerning women seem to find me attractive. God knows why.
Yes.
Look, Muriel, there is something I must tell you. You're tall, Percy.
Yes.
This afternoon, I met the woman of my dreams.
Oh, Percy!
Good evening.
Cunning, throbbing, I want you to be the first to know Arthur of Art. It will be Arthur of Art. Separation City, I'm afraid.
You'll have to congratulate us.
You and him? I think you must be mistaken. This man is engaged to my fiancée, Miss Wicksteed.
No, you must be mistaken. You are engaged to your fiancée, Miss Wicksteed.
That's what I thought until this afternoon.
This afternoon? What happened this afternoon?
I was present when he proposed.
Percy and Connie?
He proposed. She accepted. I protested. Then had to get my skates on for Evensong.
Evensong on ice? Church must be desperate.
Percy! Are you or are you not engaged to my sister-in-law?
Is your sister-in-law a woman with a nondescript face, but an outstanding figure?
Certainly not. She has a bust like a billiard table.
She's as slim and as graceful as a boy.
Perhaps that's what attracted me to her in the first place.
Sometimes I think Paul died in vain.
Certainly a person purporting to be Miss Winston thrust herself upon me this afternoon. I can still feel her urgent young body rippling beneath my fingers.
It's not like Connie to thrust herself, even slightly.
He must have led her on.
It's animal magic.
It's being a little. They have to assert themselves.
Watch it, Vicar! I gave your sister-in-law no encouragement at all.
Then kind of explain, Lofty, how you became to be without your trousers.
Percy! Is this true? No! Yes! President of the BMA, physician to the Queen, I can have any girl I want. Small,
than that, and I'll do it again. Professional misconduct, interfering with patients, a list of charges as long as my arm.
That's not very long.
What?
Please don't do it. For my sake.
For your sake. What have you ever done for me apart from pull the wool over my eyes?
It was nice while it lasted.
It was an illusion.
It always is.
No. I shall break him. He's had his chips.
No.
No. The party's over, Doctor. Curtains. This is the end of the line for you, Arthur Wicksteed, a general practitioner from Brighton's home.
Think of it. The shame. The disgrace. The poverty.
Ah! I need to let the media out too, Rome.
So you see now, marriage is out of the question.
Is it?
Oh, yes. What I've done, you can't forgive. This foul, foul thing.
It was only kissing.
No.
I must. It's my principle.
I'm a harlot! A Jezebel!
I know.
Oh!
Oh, can't you see how infinitely more desirable you are? Just see the vistas opening up.
I think I can, oh God.
I wanted you before, I want you twice as much now.
No, please, Harold, no!
Perhaps I might write Frank and Phyllis accounts for activities in the Church Times. Just think of it. Oh, such sin. But it won't be sin, because we're married and free. I must go tell the merger, I'm sure to be a merger, I think someday soon.
No, no!
I can't believe my luck. I'm going to break my jacket off.
It's kiss and makeup time. I'm glad to see someone's doing a sensible thing.
Now, Muriel, old girl, you're going to have to play your cards pretty carefully if you don't want to end up on the discard path. Oh, and I don't know. And me with the menopause just shoving its nose above the horizon as if I didn't have enough on my plate.
I filled up my 25 years in the medical profession. I put in my 20-odd years of marriage, plus a slightly threadbare respectability. And that's it. All in 10 minutes. 10 minutes, and the world turns. Our world. In Memphis, Tennessee, 14 babies have been born since this play began. In Hobart, Tasmania, a flower turns to the sun. And in Lima, Peru, an old man is dying. Birmingham, England, two lovers turn to each other in the silence of the night. And somewhere out there, in the singing silence of space, a tin flag flutters. Our world, somewhere between the loving and the lying, and the kissing and the crying, and the living and the dying, and the fishing and the frying, is that something we call life? Our world.
All packed, I see.
A few things I've thrown together.
Where are you going?
Relatives.
Close relatives.
Stephen, I think I have an aunt there.
You stink, Arthur Wicksteed, do you know that?
Yes.
A rotter!
Funny, having you, I didn't want you. Losing you, now I want you again.
Hard cheese.
And his wife who promised to stand by you.
What?
I was just thinking. Maybe it would look better if you stood by me. Maybe I wouldn't be struck off.
It would look better. Of course, I'd have to dress the part. One thing I've learned tonight is that a few right-thinking people can withstand a really good twin set of girls. But what about my feelings?
Well, I was forgetting those.
As usual. After all, she wasn't just something on the side, was she? There have been others.
A few.
A few?
Quite a few.
Oh, I'm fed up!
I think I am too. Muriel, I suppose it's too late to start again.
Much too late. All those women lie between us.
And in your life, no one?
No one, nothing, never.
Tercy?
A dream, a fantasy. No one has ever laid a finger on me except you, and you it's so long. I've almost forgotten. but to overlook your disgraceful conduct.
Shameful, shameful conduct. Filthy conduct.
Yes.
If only you could be big enough.
Then there'd have to be different going on.
How?
No more twin beds.
But I sleep so badly.
Then we shall sleep badly together.
Yes, we will.
And perhaps in the long watches of the night, I shall bring you comfort.
Perhaps you will.
There's no perhaps about it. So you have no rights, Arthur Wicksteed. They've been forfeited over the years. Whereas innocence has kept mine intact. Kiss me.
Here?
Yes. No, hard!
If you insist.
And that's the way it's going to be. Now you can either take it or leave it. But I'm not forcing you.
This, my aunt in Stevenage. I suppose I'd best take it.
A wise choice. Now, I think I might retire for a little nap.
But I'm not tired.
Excellent. Neither am I.
Muriel, what? Nothing.
See, innocence will always triumph in the end.
Though if there was anyone in your life, I'd forgive you.
No need. There was nobody. Nobody at all. Now, what are we talking about? The future.
No, no, no. It's the past.
Then we must listen to the voice of the future. Has anybody seen more treasures?
Who is this man?
I don't know. Probably a patient left over from surgery.
No, he's not my patient.
I'm not anybody's patient.
Then you've got no business here! Get out!
You again. No! Please don't touch me! No! Keep off!
Odd. He seems to know you.
In my voluntary work, I rub shoulders with four sorts.
Please don't touch me. You protect me, won't you?
Against what?
Against her!
I don't want to touch you!
You did before!
Hold your tongue!
Before? Before what? Muriel?
I don't know. How am I supposed to know?
She's a monster.
She is not a monster. She is my wife.
She's sex mad.
I wear the corsets in this house, so shut the case on before I give you burnt to fives!
Is there something between you and this man?
No, Arthur. Don't say things like that, or we can't be friends. It's quite plainly a delusion.
A delusion? Is this a delusion? Or this, the camera cannot lie.
Yeah, what wonderful pictures. Who is it?
Who? It's her.
Good God. So it is. Muriel, what have you got to say?
Silliness! Silliness, that's all it was!
Is this your clear conscience? Yes, for sake of Psalm, Dan. Not to mention your Psalm.
Damn! Damn, I'm ruined!
Is this your innocence? Or this?
Stop it!
So, now it is my turn. Don't touch me! Don't touch me! You're not fit to touch me.
It was a mistake.
And don't grovel. I can't abide a groveler. You see, I always had this sneaking suspicion that no one else fancied her. But if I hadn't married her, no one would. But, my goodness, it's forever amber all over again. Flower arrangements, cake decorating, all those long suburban afternoons. It was lovers, lovers from all walks of life, like you. How long has this been going on?
10 minutes this afternoon, that's all!
I don't believe it. I think it's been going on for years. Sex isn't something that happens overnight, you know.
You're wrong, so wrong!
Go to your room and pack one or two things just in case. You may have to go to your mother's. And you, get out! Get out!
Arthur.
Yes?
Am I to be turned out of my own home?
Well, I was.
Can't we forgive and forget and live on the memories?
I have no memories. only scars.
Oh, the blue!
No, Muriel. And the eyes. Cool, but kind of. They looked back, unflinchingly, from the glass. There was pain in those eyes. A hint, perhaps, of some secret sorrow. He ran his lean brown fingers through his thinning hair and sighed. And yet, at the corner of his firm yet delicate mouth, there lay the merest suspicion of a smile. I'm still in the game, he thought.
I see. You're still in your own nipples. And the same pair, too. Have you never heard of the dictum? Only things worn twice, and not quite nice. And we talk of comprehensive education.
Stop! It's the dirtiest gas open I have ever put my head in!
You ask me,
He wants a kick up the arse.
Come, Felicity. It's time we were going. When I hear the word arse, I know which way the wind is blowing.
Lady Rumpus! Arthur, one moment wait.
Bad news for all of us pretty well headed for the sea in yellow. It's time hurrying footsteps all around nowadays, isn't it? Now, Dennis. He's not a glamour puss. Never will be. Even though he is the fruit of our loins. Hardly our fault, you see. Funny boy, difficult to love. Never really liked touching him much. And quite frankly, it makes a difference. Touching, looking, loving. Why, without it, which one of us would thrive? Look at your girl, Felicity. Stroked and cherished all her life. Lovely girl.
Lovely girl.
Lovely girl.
But that's because she's been born next to the heart. Result, she blooms. Dennis, shoved away at the back of a drawer. Result, drab, boring, spotting. Nobody wants him.
But that's me, too.
But I say, love him as your girl seems uncountably to love him. And he'll blossom.
I think he's looking better already.
Oh, no, never! It's quite right you should be kind to him. You are his mother. I am under no such handicap.
Please!
No!
Please!
No!
Please!
No!
Please!
No, my daughter!
Oh, stuff your daughter!
He already has!
What?
Did I strike the wrong note?
Excuse me, I am a doctor.
We know you're a doctor.
He has fainted.
Quite true. Between 10 past and 3:25, they're coming down. The docking procedure.
You mean you and her? Jones! You?
Yes.
What was it like?
After all my precautions, God tossed away on me.
No, it was love.
Love? You don't understand. No one understands the shame, the waste my own shame. Story all over again.
Oh, crumbs.
Many years ago, I was a little children than Felicity is now. I just ran the colonies when I found out I was... You have to know this, Felicity. I should have told you sooner. I just ran the colonies when I found out I was... We are reaching an end.
Pregnant?
Pregnant.
Pregnant? I was not married at the time.
What about General Rumpus?
Tiger! And I met soon afterwards. He loved me, I respected him. We married. He was a gentleman, but shy. He only went to the army in order to put some moustache to good purpose. He was glad of a child, for his life had its secrets too. A passing out party at Sandhurst had left him forever incapable of having children. He threw the blank to his name, oh, Felicity, and together we achieved respectability. Call me fool, call me slut. Call me anything you like, but I vowed at the time the same thing wouldn't happen to my child. And now it has. Oh, Felicity, Felicity!
Well, where is he now? Her real father?
Do you not think I've asked myself that question? Lying under mosquito nets. Do you not think that question has hammered itself into my brain?
Well, have you any clues?
One morning, he was a doctor. Yes, that is why I despise your profession.
His name. Do you not at least know that?
No, I suppose that shocks you.
Nothing could shock me anymore.
Picture the scene. The blitz at its height. I am bound for the forest. Our convoy is assembled and ready to set sail on the morning tide. Suddenly, I am told I cannot see.
Yes?
No, I have no vaccination to do it. The blackout. An air raid of revolvers. Docks ablaze. I set off alone to find a doctor. Buildings crashing all around me. Crash, crash, crash. Bombs raining down on the street. Boom, boom, boom. I see a brass plate. The surgery in the darkness. The doctor at the table. He writes in the city. I am grateful. Think of how grateful I was. Talk?
Yes, go on.
The darkness of a surgery. His hand steals into my eye.
Then what did he do?
Then we cling to each other as the bombs fell.
Now.
Oh, I need not tell you the rest.
They always miss out the best bits.
The all clear sounds and I stumble back on board.
come dawn, we slipped out of the Mersey and headed for the open sea. Do you know the Allied Corps? No, it is very rough. I thought I was only when we docked it I realised I had a bun in the club.
Tragic.
Wonderful.
I blame the war.
Ah, yes, war. That was a strange and wonderful time. Oh, Mavis and Audrey and Lillian and Jean, Patricia and Pauline and Nappy and Christine, Maureen and Myrtle, I had you one more. In God's gift to the lecture, the Second World War.
In shelters and bunkers, omniscient applause, they wrestle with webbing and cellular drawers. From pillbox on headland, they scour the sea, while pinching our bottoms and stroking our knees.
Echoes the music drift into the night. Never in peace will it all seem so right.
Oh, lost generation, where are you now? I still see the Negro, the bonds in Slough. Mothers like you, with girls in their twenties, and fathers like me, we all share such memories.
One mad magenta moment that I paid for all my life. Felicity, ruin!
We don't know she is, do we? One swallow doesn't make a summer.
After all, Mummy, he wants to marry me.
Yes! Go, Felicity, be happy!
Happy? Only you knew.
Such a waste.
At least some lord is happy.
Is she happy?
She looks happy to me, but then I'm a behaviourist.
You're a busybody.
And I can make her happier still.
Nobody can make me happier.
I can. I want to explain about Denny.
No, Mrs. Swan, no.
What a short time we have together.
But it isn't.
It's 3 months.
No.
No?
No.
Longer?
Yes.
No.
Much longer.
Much, much longer.
You mean he isn't going to die at all?
Strong as a horse.
Oh, no.
As I say, there was a blackout. I only saw his face in a fit full of light of a post-coital craven egg. He was small, but perfectly proportioned. In some respects, more so. I don't believe I shall ever find him.
Who knows? One day the doorbell will go, and he'll walk back into our lives.
Isn't that the doorbell?
Don't let's just conclude. It could be the man next door taking his first tentative steps on the xylophone.
Sir Percy Shorter!
I wish to speak to your daughter. My daughter's been spoken to by at least 4 people this afternoon, one of whom has proposed marriage. Naturally, she is exhausted. I wish to take down her evidence.
You've taken down quite enough this afternoon.
Lies! Lies!
Evidence? What sort of evidence?
She has this very afternoon being assaulted. Suffice to say, my daughter is to marry the person who assaulted her.
But he is married already.
To this lady?
Well,
indeed! She has been masquerading as his mother. These are new deaths.
Understandably, Sir Percy here is a little confused.
Little?
He is overexcited. You are overexcited.
That is not true. I have never been more calm in my life. I am the only person here telling the truth. Unclean, unclean, I'll break you. Under cover of medical examination, this man assaulted your daughter. You! My daughter seems to have been assaulted by the whole family.
No, not me.
No, not you. You confined yourself to our friend in the shirt tails. You're the prey of the tomcat that knocks at the door.
You can talk.
You can talk.
You can talk.
Oh!
I seem to be the only one with nothing to be ashamed of.
Now I remember you. You are the beast of the 1026. Just because you're a clergyman, you think you can look a girl's legs.
I thought you said that's not true. Hell, don't touch me.
Don't touch me. Don't touch me. All your faults, the stuff you put in your hair, your terrible feet, your awful trousers. For 3 months, yes, I could have swallowed it all. String vests, everything.
times at the end of the 3 months.
That's all very nice of you, but you have been saved. Don't touch me! Oh, God.
Don't touch me!
Don't touch me!
Don't touch me!
Don't touch me!
All in all, I can say quite confidently, I've seen nothing like this since I was a locum in Liverpool.
And now, suddenly the air is black with the wings of chickens coming up your roof.
Did say Liverpool.
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 Liverpool?
Yes, Liverpool. What of it? I did a locum there in the war.
Oh, of course. The war.
That would be the second war. The war to make the world safe for democracy. That was how it was advertised.
When the enemy was always listening and cigarettes were too penny.
Put that light out.
That's him! That's him!
Who?
My Sir Juicer!
Are you all mad?
Liverpool, the wall, the docks, yes.
No.
Bombs crashing down, hail, streets ablaze, yes.
No, no.
A doctor's surgery, yes.
I don't remember.
Your surgery.
No.
And then a knock comes at the door. It is a patient. A woman.
It could have been anybody.
But it wasn't anybody.
It was nobody. Nobody! It was me! You! Don't you remember how we clung to each other in the darkness of the surgery?
Yes, yes. Tell them how it is.
No! The men who took me.
Yow!
I took you! You took me! Your lend army breeches came down with fluency, born of long practice.
It is immaterial!
Could we go over that bit in more detail?
No!
Missed that again!
When I was a child, she lived and found powerful friends. She is living now. She's a lady and very beautiful.
And I love her!
What's the matter with her?
Well, it must be something of a shock to find out she's got you for a father.
Father? Me? Bless her! To think, all these years denied the chance of leveraging on her fatherly affections, those little services of love which are a father's right. Stroke her hair, wipe away her tears, Bathe her? Perhaps no, but help her choose her dresses and rub on her suntan lotion. Those 101 things which only a father can do. You can see she needs a father's hand.
No, not down her blouse.
Ah, I see you haven't changed. No word of regret. The instant I vanished from my mind.
You funny little man.
Don't say that. Rumpus was a little man too. He made no secret of his height. Strange. I've been searching for you all my life, and now that I've found you, I don't know what to do with you.
You've got nothing to do with me. You don't even seem sorry.
Why should I be sorry? I didn't know there was a child.
And are you in the habit of seducing every patient who comes into your surgery?
It was the war.
And Lady Rumpus was your patient?
No, you were the doctor. I was the patient! Infelicity was the outcome!
Tut, tut, tut. Hard lines, Purse.
Don't call me Purse. I am Sir Percy Shorter, President of the VMA.
Well, not for much longer.
You wouldn't dare!
I would! Unprofessional conduct, interfering with patients, a list of charges as long as your arm. No, my arm. And the chief witness, your own illegitimate daughter. I think it's sleeping dog's time, Purse. Otherwise, one more word, and it's curtains finito.
It's not fair. Why does it always happen to me?
How extraordinary. So even you, Percy, are human. Just like all the rest of us the world over. Each one of us walking this world because someone, somewhere, happened to bring their body and lay it against another body. Everyone, every person you see in the street, read about in the newspaper, all the names in the births column, all the names in the deaths column, the Chinese swimming rivers with guns in their mouths, the Ryder Cup team, the Pope on his balcony. Everybody, everywhere, all the time.
Sir Percy, could I drink the boon?
She's mad too. They're all in the plot.
Examine Dennis. Ellery's dying. Chris
something tells me you're the lady we're looking for. Miss Wicksteed?
Yes.
Allow me. There. Stroking without being indiscreet. Fool, but not vulgar. What a day. Would you like to take a walk?
In the street. Won't people stare?
If a stroking woman. Yes, people will stare.
I shall need different clothes. A larger fit. My hair ought to be different. My whole style.
Come, the world is awaiting.
There's no doubt about it. Brett Palsy.
Brett Palsy. How terrible. How terrible, Felicity.
Don't overdo it.
In its tertiary stage.
Tertiary. That's good. Tertiary. Good. Tertiary.
That's very good.
How long have I got?
Do you really want me to tell you?
For the sake of my fiancé. Yes.
Your ex-fiancé. I give you back the ring.
In the circumstances, wise precaution. The engagement would have been broken off anyway.
You mean?
I'm afraid so. 3 months. 4 at the outside.
You're sure? President of the British Medical Association. Physician to the Queen. A man in his position can't afford to make mistakes. Can you?
No. Forgive me.
So I do have Brett Palsy after all. I always said I had Brett Palsy. Felicity, how could you ever doubt I had Brett Palsy? Time is short. We must be married this minute.
Across the lawns of life, they walk into the sunset.
congratulations, Rex. Who knows what day I might just be a guesser for the press. My life, I've sworn to a hating, but let my chance go by. One day will lead to heaven, that Matlock in the sky.
That's a refreshing change. The first time this evening, everyone's had their trousers on.
My face and my past begins to race.